Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I'm going to take you through some advanced topics on earned value analysis. So in the last video, we have seen what is earned value analysis using a simple problem. I'll be explaining the advanced topics about earned value analysis with the same problem. So let us see first those advanced topics. The earned value analysis has two stages, that is tracking, the first one, and the forecasting is the second one. Tracking means it says the present performance about the cost and time for a project, about the present performance. Okay, so what is forecasting? So considering the present performance values, we are going to forecast like how these values will affect the project. That is what forecasting is. So when I say it with definition, forecasting is about how the present performance will affect the future performance about the cost and time. So let us see this in the software for the better understanding. So I'll close this. I'll go to the software. So we have seen in the last problem, what was this earned value cost, right? So now we have to go to check what is the tracking value and the what is the forecasting value. So let us now go to enterprise and tracking. Got it? So you'll be taken to this window where you'll have to make few changes. So as you can see, I have already set the columns that I want. So if you're not able to see, just right click, good columns, customize, make sure you are having these many options: budget at completion or BAC, actual cost AC, earned value cost EVC, planned value, schedule performance index, cost performance index, estimate to complete, estimate at complete, variance at complete. So these are the columns that you want. These values you need. I'll tell you what are they. So in the last problem, I'll open the problem. So this is the problem that I solved to explain you what is earned value analysis. So let's go with the same problem. So here, when we came to the tracking, I went to enterprise, then tracking. When I went to that, I can see BAC. These values will automatically come. So BAC means this BAC, budget at completion, how much we plan to spend for this particular project. Then we have actual cost. That is this one, how much we spent on that day. At the end of seventh day, we finished only 50% of work. At the same time, we spent 900 rupees out of 1000 rupees. So this 900 rupees is this one, actual cost. Earned value cost is, see, for the 50% of work, as per the plan, we should have spent 100 rupees per day. In the same way, for 5 days. For 5 days, 500 rupees. Why? Because each day we'll be finishing 10% of work. For 50% of work, we need to have 5 days of work. So each day we are spending 100 rupees. So for 5 days, 500 rupees. That is the earned value cost. Planned value cost means, see, on this day, at the end of seventh day, we should have finished 70% of work. We should have finished 70% of work. Each day, we are going to finish 10% of work and we are spending 100 rupees. So, for 70% of work, we'll be spending 700 rupees as per the plan. So, this was the planned cost. Got it? Now we have schedule performance index and cost performance index. Schedule performance index and cost performance index. So schedule performance index means we have 0.71 value, right? So if the value is lesser than 1, we are behind schedule. It means we are behind schedule. The project is going to get delayed. It means if the value of schedule performance index is lesser than 1, it means the project is going to delay. If it was more than 1, means we are finishing the project earlier than the project finish date. Got it? The cost performance index means here we have 0.56. This is all the same way. If we have value lesser than 1, that means we are going to spend more money. We are going to spend more money. You can see in the problem, right? At the end of 7th day, we have finished only 50% of work and we have already spent 900 rupees. So looking at the problem itself, we can understand that the project is going to get delayed and we are going to spend more money. So understood, right? These two values. So starting from here, BAC, AC, EBC, PVC, SPI, CPI, these many values come under tracking. So when you say what is the present performance of the project, you have to show these values from here to here. Starting from here to here are the values. Okay, starting from here to here, the values related to tracking. Then these many estimate. When we look at estimate, we can understand that is it is just something about forecasting. Estimate, right? Estimate forecasting. See the relation. Estimate to complete, this one estimated complete. Variance at complete. In the short form, we call them ETC, EAC, and VAC. So, what do they mean? So, I'll tell you. Estimate to complete means. So, estimate to complete means how much more money we need to complete this project. So, that is what this estimate to complete means. How much extra money we need. From now on, from here, next, how much money we need? Money we need is the estimate to complete. So estimated complete is 1400, right? That is nothing but 500 plus this 900. So total, how much you are going to spend? Total, not from here, but from the beginning up to the end of the project, how much you are going to spend is the estimated complete, which is nothing but 900 plus 500. 500 plus this 900. Got it? Next comes the variance at complete. Variance at completion. So this is 400, right? So this is nothing but how much money extra you need, how much extra money you need to complete this project from this point, how much extra money you need. You have just 100 rupees balance, right? We have spent 900 already from 1000, so you have 100 rupees balance from this one left. So extra 400 you need again, not including this 100. Extra 400 you need. Can you understand? So this is the total amount that we want out of this 1000 we had, right? So x of 400, there is a bracket, right? That means a negative value, means we need to add extra. Extra means this bracket will have. Got it, right? So that is variance at completion. So these three, estimate to complete, estimate at complete, variance at complete, this is about the forecasting. So in the forecasting, we have these many, and under tracking, we have these many. So this is how you calculate the tracking and forecasting. So I hope you all understood the video. If you have any doubts, you can comment below. If you want to get daily updates on my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.